And welcome, everybody, to this edition of Protestant News, this little teaser for the upcoming program. I'm your host, Brother Dan Goodwin. I have in the studio here again Brother Michael Samuel Smith. And we have his brand new DVD that we talked about a little bit last week, and we're going to hit this pretty hard this week. It's called The Samson Paradox, and you can get that at protestantnews.com, or you can call the 800 number during business hours and get this. Let me read a verse for you, and then I'm going to let Brother Samuel Smith here, we're going to let him tell us a little bit about what's on the DVD. I want to read a verse for you in Judges chapter 14, verse 14. It says this, "He said unto them, out of the eater came forth meat, and out of the strong came forth sweetness." That's a riddle that Samson gave, and he wanted them to see if they could come up with the answer to the riddle. And Brother Smith, glad to have you. We're going to do another show.
All right.
And listen, this is the riddle that you make such a big deal of in this DVD.
Yes.
In fact, you said it's possibly the most important part of the whole story of Samuel. Now, don't give away the whole thing, but tell us a little bit about why this riddle is so important and maybe what it leads to.
Well, to start off with, I'd say about 80% of the things we talk about in this DVD about the Samson Paradox that people have never heard before. There's a lot more to this story. In fact, there's an entirely different dimension to this story with Samson because there's so many golden nuggets in this story, and people just kind of go through those four chapters and it's just, there's nothing important in there. It's not just a piece of history. So essentially, what's being played out is when you look at the whole story, Samson is a representation of Israel, past, present, and future. And you can see, when you look back through from the time of Abraham 4,000 years ago to today, you can see all these events happening through their history in the context of that one story with Samson. So it's very, very important. But I have never heard the answer to the riddle in a Sunday school, or I have never heard a preacher preach about what the answer is. Now, there is an immediate answer in chapter 13, and I should say 14, 18. But that's not the ultimate answer. The ultimate answer is not found in the Old Testament. It's found in the New Testament.
And we're going to look at that in this week's program. We're going to look at what this riddle means and how it's answered and when you get to the New Testament.
Yes.
The other thing I want you to talk about in the program we're going to do shortly is the three women in Samson's life.
Yes.
And one of them's the first one's a Gentile, right?
That's correct.
He marries a Gentile.
That's correct.
Just like Joseph married a Gentile, and there's a prophetic story there. So we'll talk about that in the show. So folks, don't miss the show this week coming up. You can see it on YouTube, usually out on Wednesdays. But also you can see it on television, wherever you live. It's on CTN and many other local stations out there. So don't miss the show this week. We're going to bring out some really tremendous prophetic things that you've probably never heard before out of Brother Smith's DVD here. I think you're going to enjoy it. So tell your friends about it. Share this with your friends. Tell them to listen in. And Brother Mike, thanks for coming on for this brief little teaser for the program. And listen, till next time, keep looking up. Keep your eyes on the skies.